They came to Canada from Colombia in October. Two of the first things they did, start English classes and visit the food bank. It was such a shock because we're not used to this kind of support. I remember looking at my daughter. Our eyes were wide open. It's a big change from their life in Bogota. Marcela was a preschool teacher. Martin drove a truck. They had enough money. The problem there was safety. Martin says they had to get out.
Sí, eminentemente.
Yes, it was urgently necessary. Our lives were in danger. According to a new report, one-third of people using Ontario's food banks are new immigrants. Many of them are highly educated. Mississauga has had one of the biggest jumps in food bank use. Staff and volunteers here are becoming creative in trying to help people.
Everything, like, I mean, for a bank statement, literally I've drawn pictures of a bank with, like, money signs going, please bring me a bank statement so, you know, we can get your paperwork done.
But she is picking up words here and there, mostly in Spanish and Arabic. Her Gujarati and Hindi come in handy, too. Martina and Marcela are relieved they're getting help, but they're already thinking about the future, and they won't need it. Lorena Redicock, CBC News, Mississauga.
We're celebrating Sounds of the Season all week, and if you want to help us help GTA food banks, drop by the Canadian Broadcasting Center here in downtown Toronto. We have donation bins ready to go, and this Friday we'll have more special programming here on CBC News Toronto and on CBC Radio 1. To find out how you can be a part of it, go to our website, cbc.ca/Toronto. Well, if you're a fan of going on,